Hi guys, what's good? I'm JJ from the KCLD Playhouse. Happy to be able to kind of help you guys figure out what you want to do for careers. So a quick rundown of what I do every single day. Honored to be part of this, so thanks for letting me do this. I'm going to give you a quick rundown of some things that I do every day, kind of how I got into the radio career, and hopefully it can help set you along the guidelines of whether or not this is something you want to do or if it's just an interest you have. So some of the questions that were sent to me right away, just kind of prerequisite questions, is what led to a career in radio for me. It was a stupid way. There's a lot of people that say, hey, I sat in front of the radio and I talked when the DJ talked or whatever stuff. It wasn't for me. This was a really weird way that I got into radio. So I went to college and I was pre-law. And I took a quick internship, clerking, I guess if you want to call it, at a law firm one summer between my junior and senior years of college, and decided quickly that I did not want to become a lawyer. And I had all this college debt, and I didn't know what else. I just kind of finished. I had gotten cut my senior year of playing baseball in college, and didn't know what I wanted to do. And my roommate and I, we were sitting around one day watching a Cubs game. And he's like, oh, you played baseball, you should do that. And I'm like, I don't know what that is. And he said, you should be on the radio or on TV doing, sports. And I thought, oh, that could be really, really cool. And so I went to broadcast school for a couple of months. And next thing you know, I'm in radio. So I kind of fell backwards into radio, but I love it. Just being able to have fun with people every single day. A lot of people don't get to do that for their career. So I laugh every day, which is kind of cool. So that's how I got into radio. Like I said, a lot of people just go straight from high school into broadcast school, or they decide that they're going to go to college for 4 years and then get into radio and get an internship. For me, it was... I literally was sitting around one night not knowing what to do. I had $100,000 in school loans. I was a failed baseball player, and I fell backwards into radio. What do I enjoy about being on the air? Man, this is it. I get to laugh every day. I get to do fun stuff with you guys like this, but I get to just have fun with really cool people every single day, and it's hard. It's getting up at 2:30 in the morning, and it's a lot more than just a couple hours you hear on the radio. There's a lot of stuff that goes into preparing for a show, and then everything afterwards, whether it's social media, the podcast, live events that we've got to be at and stuff like that. But what I really, really enjoy is the 4 o'clock to 9 a.m., those 5 hours of being in the studio and having fun. And hopefully it comes across on the air and people enjoy it, because there's a lot of just icky in the world right now. And if we get a chance to have some fun and maybe kind of be a cool little escape for people, that's what I dig on the most. Schooling, I touched on it real quick. If you do want to get into radio, there's a lot of different ways. There's not a prerequisite. I know to be a doctor, you've got to go to a doctor, to medical school and stuff like that. But for radio, there's a lot of people that just go straight into radio. They don't even go to school for it. If you are in high school and you can grab an internship at a radio station and work your way up, radio is more based on experience than education. Mostly, especially on the music formats. If you get into some formats like news talk and stuff like that, they're going to look for people that had probably English majors. Public speaking is a big deal, obviously. But if you know how to write the news, well, and as far as your English goes and your writing skills go, that'll help you as far as like a news talk will go. So otherwise, I encourage people to just go to a four-year school and get your degree. Oh, hi.
Hi.
Do you guys need the studio?
For what?
For anything?
Oh, no.
Oh, I'm just filming this for some kids, for career choices. And so a lot of people, like Kat, went to broadcast school. She went for like 16, 18 months, and then boom, got her a job in radio. I always tell people one of the hardest things in radio is finding something to talk about. So I encourage a lot of people, go to 4 years of college if you want to. I mean, if that's your plan, have fun, make friends, get life experiences, and then you got something to talk about on the radio. So there's no real prerequisite as far as your schooling goes. It's kind of up to you, but you will need something to talk about. So, life goes along. Long way. What interests do would I find to be like good in radio? If you're an introvert and you know it and you like just being home watching Netflix, radio is probably not for you. Now there's a lot of people that I've worked with that are really, really good on the radio, but then we get them out in public or they have to host an event and they just clam up and they're not good in front of people. So if you feel like you can't overcome that or that's not your forte, then radio probably isn't for you. You could podcast from your home. There's a lot of other avenues to go. But as far as like if you want to be on the radio and do afternoons like Derek or do mornings like us or whoever is kind of, your favorite jock, being able to talk to a lot of people all the time, I mean, it's very weird to press a button and know that hundreds of thousands of people can be listening to your every word. So if that wigs you out a little bit, then radio's probably not for you. And you gotta have a pretty thick skin because it's really competitive. I mean, just in our environment, there's, you know, most people just driving down the street can hear 25 or 30, maybe even more radio stations. So, you know, you've got to understand that you're not going to win every time, and that not everybody, the other weird thing is like 90% of people don't like us or don't choose to listen to us, but those 10% make us, you know, okay, we do well. And it's very weird. You got to have a different angle and realize that the people that you are entertaining and that you're making an impact on are way different and way fewer than the people you're not. So it's a little bit of a weird thing. You got to have a thick skin and kind of forget early and be able to move on. A day in the life real quick is get up, come on in. And with Kat and I, we have a little bit of a different situation because our show is heard in a bunch of different markets. So we get here, and then we prepare those markets for our show. And one of them is on the East Coast in Montreal, Quebec, Canada. And so they're an hour ahead of us. And you know, one of them's in Florida, and then a couple are on the Midwest here. So out of the six or seven stations we're on, we have to help those guys get their shows ready before we do the live show here. So we spend usually about an hour getting those guys material and anything they want. If they send us stuff that they want us to read for their radio station, we just kind of spend that time prepping our show, and then our show goes live here at 5:30, runs till 9. We have a quick after show meeting, you know, deciding what we need to do, get ready for tomorrow. And then for me, I oversee the radio station as a whole, so I've got some other meetings and stuff to kind of get everything else together, and other talent to talk to. You know, we make music decisions every Monday, promotions meeting, what's going on when we're not in a coronavirus situation. So a day in the life is usually I'm here at 3:30, maybe 4 sometimes, and try and get gone by noon, and then kind of work off my phone or my laptop after that with emails and stuff like that. I have a mic at home, a microphone at home, which is, it's not great, but I can get stuff done if we really need to get stuff done. So that's a quick day in the life. What I will do is kind of wrap this up for you guys real quick, but if you do ever have questions about radio or what it takes or, you know, anything like it all, definitely hit up our webpage. It's 1047kcld.com. You can find Kat's email address there. You can find mine there. Get us on socials. It's mine is just JJ Holiday on Facebook. I think it's JJ Holiday 1047kcld on Instagram and stuff like that, whether you want Snapchat. All those links, like I said, it all starts on our webpage at 1047kcld.com. So listen, radio is super competitive, and it's not easy, and it's getting diluted. I'm not trying to discourage you in any way, but I'm telling you, if you kind of only want to do it, it's not going to work out. Not too many people kind of stick with this for their entire career when they only just kind of want to do it as a hobby, or hey, I want to impress a girl and play whatever song that she wants to hear, stuff like that. It is cool to get concert tickets for free and stuff like that, but outside of, it's a grind, it's a hard job, and it's a lot of hours, and it's a lot of weekends and overnights and stuff like that when you start out, and it's not glitz and glamour for a long, long time, but when it is, it's super fun. Like I said, we have a lot of fun every day. So if you're looking for something and you're passionate about communicating with other people, making them laugh, communicating some good news to them, or just, you know, whatever the angle is, radio could be super cool for you. But just understand that it is a grind. It's not a I'm going to put on a shirt and a tie and, you know, work for my uncle for 40 hours a week. So again, if you have any questions, for sure hit us up. Start at the webpage at 1047kcld.com. Hope this offered some clarity into what you might be doing eventually one day. And I want to give you a quick tour of what's going on around here before we leave. So there's Kat working on her computer. Our studio, and I can kind of give you, if you came in the door, this is our studio. And, you know, obviously we've got, you know, the computers and everything in front of us, the board, where everything happens. And, you know, obviously all of our music and everything you hear on the air comes through our computer. We don't have any CD players, record players, anything in here anymore. Everything is digital audio. And there's where our phone lines come through. And there's where our digital editing happens. And that's basically the studio. So we have other studios in the building, Wild Country 99, Light 99.9, our news talk station KNSI, and then Z-Rock, all in the same building. All kind of, you can see some of them through the windows here. There's KNSI, our newsroom, And other than that, there's not much else to show you because nobody else is here because of the coronavirus. But like I said, if you ever have any questions or whatever, hit us up. We'd be happy to answer those. And I hope this offered you a little bit of clarity into what the world of radio is like. Have a great day, guys.